You're ready to create a professional development plan, but you want to create one that sticks. In today's video, I'm going to show you the career planning process of my success strategy planning process that's one that's actually going to stage you for success. Stay tuned. In my last video, I shared with you a framework for career success planning. If you work for a big company, you've been through at least a portion of this process before. The annual goal setting and maybe even creating an action plan to bring it to life. But the reason that most people grumble about it and either fail to put in an effort to creating a plan or fail to put in effort to actually using that plan in any meaningful way is that most career success plans don't actually address the right things. Yes, I'm telling you that the key to an effective career success plan is having the right framework. But more than framework, you have to have the right things in the right places. And in my last video, I talked you through the process, but I know that many people struggle to actually do this on their own. So in today's video, what I'm going to do is walk you through the methodology, but actually in the framework of the career success plan that I actually help my clients create. And if you stay all the way to the end of the video, I will tell you where you can download this template for yourself. Okay, so a lot of the rest of the video, I'm actually going to be showing you my screen so that you can see the relevant things in context. And you'll notice the very first thing in the success plan that I encourage you to use is defining your career vision. Yes, I have a video to help you create your vision. So if you haven't actually already done that step, I do suggest that after you watch that video, go back and watch it. I did link it in the comments. This is really going to help you as you actually develop your career success plan. Now for my plan today, I'm not showing anything from an actual life plan. This is actually somewhat derived from one of the career success plans that I created for myself many years ago. However, I've changed things because I wanted to make things applicable to as many people as possible in this video. So for our career planning process example, here you can see that the vision is listed as, in 5 years, I want to be a director at an entry to mid-sized startup and contribute to my industry by sharing my expertise to help others grow. Now, including your vision here is something that many professionals don't do, but I strongly encourage you to take the time not only to create your vision, but to include it here. If you're using your success plan in the right way, you're visiting this document and as an indirect result, your vision on a very regular basis. There's a very strong chance that your vision is going to evolve over time, especially as you accomplish more and more in your career. So having it here and being part of your fluid success plan is really important. Plus, it's going to help you as you complete the rest of the success plan to have easy access to see what your vision is and to keep it top in mind in terms of all of the milestones, goals, and tasks that you're going to set in order to help you achieve it. The second step in your career success plan is defining how you want other people to describe you. So what you're really trying to get at in this section of the career success plan is the things that people are going to say about you when you leave the room. When someone contacts a prior colleague or a prior manager for a reference interview, what are the consistent things that you want for people to say? There is a deeper process to actually uncover what these values are. And if you haven't done that, I do encourage you to do it. I won't get too far into it in this video just because it would really make it really long. And I know that some of you have already done this groundwork. However, if you do want to see that video, let me know in the comments down below and I will prioritize making it for you. Now, one of the comments that I get is that including these values, these descriptors of who you are and who you want to be, seems to be incredibly random. It doesn't always fit into, say, the tasks that you're putting into your career success plan. However, what they are doing is helping to guide you in terms of the milestones, the strategies, and yes, even occasionally the tasks that you're going to undertake. Because if you see an opportunity to build that professional brand where someone is going to say that thing about you, this is going to be the key to get to the level that you want to get as the person that you want to get there as. In our career planning process example, we can see that this person has listed 4 terms: empathetic, innovative, kind, and tenacious. These are great examples that resonate with that fictitious person who's actually just me. These are actually some of the values that I have listed in terms of who I want to be and how I want to be known. So I just left them as is here. The third step in your career success plan is defining what do you want to be known for. I'm a huge believer in the power of expertise and for being the person that is the go-to resource for that one specific thing. Now, being an authority to some people means that you're actively out there in your industry as a public face, as an expert, but this isn't for everyone. So whether your goal is to be a regular contributor on Forbes on your topic of expertise, or just be known in your company for being really good at that one thing that people are going to ask you questions, you need to define what that one thing is. And you also need to include it in your career success plan. Now, in the career success plan, I like to call this, what's your superpower? As much as possible, you're going to want to limit this to one or two things at a time. Once again, these may shift and change over time, especially as you evolve and grow through your career. However, having a couple of things that you really want to be known for is going to help people get to know you. They're going to know that they can come to you for help on those very specific topics. Now, in our career success plan example, it's still somewhat general. However, it is probably at the appropriate level for this person. They're saying that their superpower is client experience optimization and people management. Now, you might choose to hone in a little bit more if there is an opportunity to get specific, or what you might find is that over time, you actually become more specific in your superpower as you actually grow in it. So step four is creating your professional mission statement. This is actually a combination of your values and how you want to be known. A professional mission statement is very much like a personal mission statement or like a company mission statement, but this is going to be something that is focused on who you are as a professional. I know some people write a mission statement that is blanketed across all the different areas of their lives. However, I actually prefer and encourage you to have different mission statements based on the different aspects of your life. For example, I wouldn't want to be known for being a killer grilled cheese sandwich maker professionally. I don't think that it's going to help me get where I want to go in my career. However, at home, it really does serve me well because my kids really like grilled cheese sandwiches. Now, if you haven't created a professional mission statement and this is something that you know you want to do because it makes such an impact on your career, make sure that you click that subscribe button right now and the notification bell, because my video next week is going to show you exactly how you can create it. The next step is to be defining your key milestones. And this is where we really start to get into the details in the career success plan. Your key milestones are going to be directly derived from your vision. So in order to achieve your vision, you're going to want to set different markers along the way. It's smaller achievements that are going to get you to that ultimate outcome that you dream of. Now, in my last video, I gave you some tips and strategies and how to do that. So what I want to do now is I want to actually dig into this career success planning example so that you can actually see how this looks in the template that I recommend that you use. So in this example, we see that their goal is to be managing managers, which aligns them directly with a level that they want to achieve and also that they want to have spoken at a conference. Now, neither of these things is going to take 10 years or beyond, but they're actually creating the check boxes along the way so that there are things that you can achieve beyond that big 5-year thing so that you're celebrating the journey as you actually move through it. And then we get into step six, which is developing the actual plan. Now, to stay on track, and what you'll probably find as you actually go through the career planning process and setting the milestones according to your career vision, is that it's likely going to map out into annual milestones that you're going to achieve. Now, I mentioned in my last video as well, but in case you didn't see that one, I just really want to highlight here is that the success plan is going to map the milestones for when for year five up until a year from now. However, the plan focus is really going to be on the next year. The reason for that is there's so many variables that can move, shift, and change in terms of who you are, your position, and the opportunities available, that to spend a lot of time planning something that's not going to happen for 5 years would not be an effective use of your time, at least in my opinion. I want to keep you focused on the next year and in particular the next 3 to 6 months because this is going to be your best visibility. Now, just a quick caveat, I am saying this with a high amount of bias because I come from the tech industry and the tech industry moves incredibly quickly that within 3 to 6 months, your entire company may have changed. It may have acquired a company, it may have been acquired by a company. There also tends to be a lot more transitions within roles, especially to different companies on a regular basis. So that's why, especially if you're working in one of these really fast-moving industries, keeping it focused on the foreseeable future is going to serve you incredibly well, and it's going to make the success plan much more applicable to you. Now, the most important thing that we need to do in order to actually create the tasks for our plan so that we know what we need to do is know exactly what the milestones are. So in our career success example, what I've done, and I've actually consolidated this a little bit, generally a plan that I create with one of my clients would be much more robust, but just actually for the purposes of fitting on screen and not boring you to death with the intricacies, I've actually consolidated this a little bit. So their goal that we're gonna focus on for this exam, for the career success planning example, is being a speaker at a conference within the next 12 months. And one thing, as well as one thing that's going to help them get to their promotion of being a manager, and that is actually creating a process. This is actually what I call an impact project. If you are curious about impact projects, what they are and how they benefit your career, feel free to leave me a comment below and I can help you out. So within 12 months, the milestones and tasks are to apply to speak and have at least one accepted. So if I were to back that out, I would actually put within 12 months to have at least 3 conference speaker applications out. Backing that up into the 3 months, there is a draft of the session, of the conference session submissions. So knowing what you actually want to submit against and having that ready to go so that when applications open, you're squared away. And then within the next 30 days, so this month, their goals and tasks are to join Toastmasters to refine their public speaking skills and to speak with their manager about promotion criteria. Because obviously speaking with your manager about how to get promoted isn't something that you want to do when you're ready for promotion. You want to be having that conversation long before you're ready and also on a continuing basis. So that's a great thing to actually have on your career success plan if you are someone who is trying to get to the next level ahead. All right, and as I mentioned earlier in the video, I have the career success plan template that I find to be the most meaningful, the most effective, and really the one that ambitious professionals find that they do actually leverage on a regular basis, which helps them actually achieve their goals, their vision, and ultimately their career dreams. Now, usually I only include this in my career accelerator, but because I was talking about it and showing it to you today, I wanted to just make the template available for you to download. So if this is something that you know would be a resource, that's an awesome thing for you to do, or you want to follow the steps of this video without having to spend the time like creating sections in a Word doc for yourself, you can actually download it for free at capdecasolutions.com/success-template. And I'll put the link down below so that you don't have to like type it out. You can actually just click that button. So make sure that you check that out. I know that it is an awesome resource and it's something that my clients always actually really enjoy, even if they've hated this process for years and years and years, or at least a few years, because generally they haven't been in the workforce for years and years and years. And one more thing that I do want to mention to you before you click away, and that is I have actually created a new Facebook community. I had so much amazing feedback here on my YouTube channel and as well as over on LinkedIn that I wanted to create a better place for us to collaborate in terms of career success, strategies, and growth. So I created the Strive Squad. It's a closed group so that we can have candid conversations. If you want to come there, hang out, get to know us, and most of all, learn and grow within the community, I will also drop that link down below. I truly hope that this video helped you create your career success plan. I know it's something that most people grumble about, so I'm so happy that you're here, you're doing it, because I know that it is going to be a resource that helps you get to the next level and the level above that. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up. It lets me know to make more just like it, and it also really helps my channel. Now, you will want to tune in for my next video. If you haven't already created your professional mission statement, because that's exactly what I'm going to show you, so click that subscribe button down below, as well as the notification bell. And if you have a friend that would be really served, sharing is caring. Thank you so much for being unapologetically ambitious and for watching this video. I truly appreciate the fact that I can be a resource to you, but mostly that you're taking the time to invest in yourself. Make sure that you do click that subscribe button before you go so that you can cultivate the career and the life that you want. And I will see you next time. Bye for now.